And everyone's back with me. I mean, Dr. Walks, what is the why? I mean, why? Why? I mean, Dr. Fauci is very direct. This is a failure, and it is a big failure. Why did this happen?
I think that question has to go to the people in charge. Dr. Fauci doesn't know. I don't know. I think it's important for us to understand the consequences, though. When we say to people, well, if you're young and you're healthy, you may have little or no symptoms, but you can transmit the virus if you're sick with the virus to someone who is in that high-risk group, but then we won't test the young and healthy folks because they're not sick enough, it absolutely makes no sense. You don't need to be a medical professional to understand that doesn't make any sense. If that's what we're doing, it's an embarrassment. There's no other word for it. It's an embarrassment, and we should do better. So we're looking to the local public health folks. We have governors, we have mayors, we have people who... See, the health people aren't the policymakers. Right. The policymakers who are local and are working closely with the health people are making good decisions. They're using that space, that distance by closing schools and what have you, to give us time, to give the health folks time to get more information, to be able to now intervene in ways that make sense. But it's an embarrassment, to answer your question.
Dr. Dodge, I mean, it's an embarrassment. And, you know, the United States, there's all kinds of issues, as I understand it. There's an issue of how many tests there are. There's an issue of their ability to extract the information from the tests. There's a shortage of the reagent needed to interpret the tests, right? There's problems across the board. When Vice President Pence was asked why the United States decided to not use the coronavirus test developed by the WHO, which was an option, he said, well, that's just not the way the United States does it. We always just do our own. Here's how we put it.
That's actually not the way we do it in the United States. Frankly, we're the world leader in infectious diseases. Our CDC and then our FDA produce and approve tests through our incredible healthcare system in this country. And so that's more of a reference of that decision, according to what Dr. Fauci said.
What's your response to that, Dr. Adalja? We just do it our own way, and if it fails, so what?
No, that's the absolute wrong way to approach this. Pandemic preparedness, one of the key pillars to it, is actually having robust diagnostic capacity. And we have really failed. And when you look back in history at this pandemic and years to come, this is going to be the story of failures of diagnostics. We should be doing what South Korea is doing. That's the model for the world. We need to know who has this infection so we can isolate them. That's the only way we're going to avoid what's happening in Italy, is to really be great at diagnosing this and being able to give people information to protect themselves and protect their loved ones. It's really something that I was surprised happened and didn't expect to happen. I thought that we would be much better off at this, and I think it really shows that we do have gaps in our pandemic preparedness, even gaps that we didn't even know we had.
So, Dr. Yasmin, you know, in terms of what the president is doing, the ramping up testing, you know, that there's all sorts of issues there. What he is doing is banning travel to and from most of Europe for most people. Right? American citizens can come and go, and you can come and go from the UK. Obviously, we all can understand how that would be incredibly leaky at best, even if it were a good idea. Mm-hmm. What is your reflection on that? I mean, is this something that is the right thing to do from an infectious disease perspective at this point?
It's not, Erin. It's a misguided policy. And we can look back in history, see during Ebola, travel bans didn't work. The World Health Organization told us so. But even right now, look at Italy. We're seeing how much of a crisis they're dealing with. And they did have a travel ban for anyone traveling from China. Look how that worked out. It didn't. But in the case of this particular policy, it's so leaky. There are so many loopholes to it. It doesn't ban everyone coming from Europe. It only bans foreign nationals. That means American citizens and green card holders could go, become infected, and come back. That doesn't make sense. But it also excludes the UK, which just saw a quite significant jump in cases. And even the UK's own health minister is infected. So it's a really bizarre policy. It's not backed by science. And it doesn't make sense to be throwing these kinds of approaches towards this pandemic.
And a virus, of course, doesn't care where you are from or what your nationality is. Dr. Adalja, quickly before we go, as an infectious disease specialist, the Brazilian press secretary with whom the president interacted, took pictures, had dinner, was side by side with him. As far as we know, President Trump has not yet been tested. Should he be? The Brazilian press secretary, to be clear, does have coronavirus.
he is a high-risk contact, and he really needs to monitor himself for symptoms. And there is some indication that we can test some of these mild cases or ones that have very, very minimal symptoms, and you might get a positive because it could be carriers, an asymptomatic carrier. So I do think it's important that he be monitored and be tested at the slightest sign of any symptom.
Right. And at best, to show people there is no stigma in any way, since this is something so many people are going to get, it is best that people understand that. Thank you all so very much.